こんにちは。
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 So, hi everyone, welcome back to our channel, and thank you for revisiting our YouTube channel today. So, in today's video, we're gonna do something different from the usual videos. So, now what is different is like, we're gonna talk about the true experiences that we had back in 2011. So, when you hear the year 2011, what can you think of? This question might be really hard and difficult, or easier for you, because you clearly remember the things happening to Japan in that year. The answer is the earthquake and tsunami that engulfed the region in northern part of Japan. Okay? Self-introduction. And in today's video, I have two guests, okay, so from my channel, okay. So, this person is Shumei, and this person is Takaya, okay. So, those two is going to introduce about themselves from now. So, first going to be first, okay. My name is Shumei.
このチャンネルでは理科と社会を教えさせてもらっています。
In this channel, I'm allowed to teach, social studies and science.
よろしくお願いします。
Nice to meet you, everyone. Okay. Takaya.
Yes. 皆さん、はじめまして。
Nice to meet you, everyone.
僕の名前は Takaya と言います。
My name is Takaya.
このチャンネルでは数学を教えています。
In this channel, I teach mathematics.
お願いします。
Okay, so, as I already talked about the earthquake happening to Japan in the introduction part, I want you to listen to some stories about the, actual experiences that we had. Okay, so from Japanese perspective, okay, in English. Alright, so, from now, I want both of you to talk freely, express yourself.About the earthquakes. For example, what you experienced in 2011 and what you were doing right after the earthquake happened. Okay, so please begin.
じゃあ、自分が小学校4年生の時、多分10歳ぐらいの時にその東日本大震災 3.11 兆円と体験しました。
Yes, so it was, when I was a 10 years old, and I was in the fourth grade of the elementary school. I experienced the tsunami and earthquake.
で、それを体験した時は家にいて、家にワイと一緒にいました。
Right after the earthquake happens, I was with my mom and I was at home.
それでも電気がつかなかったりとか、テレビが見れなかったり、そういう、そういう経験を今でも覚えているし、とても怖かったと思います。
The necessary thing for our daily lives, including water and lights and any other electricity, were all cut off, and everything was unusable. I still remember the memory.
本当にこの 3.11 っていうのは、忘れちゃいけない災害、悲劇だと思います。
Yes, so, as far as all, everything that I talked concerned, I think the, happening and the accident happening in 2011 were all unforgettable thing, and we can't forget anytime and anywhere. We always have to share the memory to those who do not know about the earthquakes.Especially those, who will be born in the future. Yeah.
自分の声で以上です。
That's all for me. So what about you?
はい、そうですね。3.11 の僕が小学校2年生の頃にあった出来事です。
So 3.11 were, occurring when I was 9 years old And I was in the second grade of the elementary school.
地震発生直後、確か僕は、まあ、歩いて買い物に行こうとしていたんですね。
So right after the earthquake happens, I was about to go shopping with Fu, with your mom.
Ah, mom.
Okay, so with his mom. And yeah, so I was spending, somehow, it was really natural in daily life, as usual, yeah.
歩いてたら、そばにあったマンションかな?マンションがすごい揺れ始めて、まあ、なんだろうっていうふうに思ったことを今でも覚えてます。
Yeah, so at that time, suddenly the mansion, like a apartment, started to shaking and shaking so heavily. And I felt like, what is going on? Like, it's really strange.
その時は何事か全然わからなかったんですけども、そのスーパーについてたくさんの人がそのお店の中から出てきてるのを見て、その時、大きな地震があったんだっていうふうなことに気がつきました。
Actually, I had no idea what was going on around me. Then, after I arrived at the supermarket, which I was about to go to, I noticed that everyone else is just, rushing out of the supermarket and running to evacuate and everyone was just trying to go out out of the restaurant, supermarket. So it was really surprising. But the accident that I exactly saw at the supermarket make me realize that, oh, earthquake is actually happening right now.
それで家に帰ってきて、まあ電気もつかないし、まあ何もできない中、まあいろいろとよく考えたのをすごい覚えてます、僕は。
So I reminisce the memory that everything was just cut off, including electricity and lights and water and everything that I think is necessary to live. So those memories are really unforgettable as well. And I still remember those memory and 10 years ago clearly.
ですね、僕の祖父と祖母、おじいちゃんおばあちゃんですね、が東北の方に住んでいて、すごい。そのことについて心配になったのを今でもよく覚えてます。
So my grandparents living in Tohoku, northern part of Japan, I was really concerned about their life and their catastrophe. Yeah. So I was really concerned anyway.
とりあえず以上で。
Okay. So both of you heard the each story from each of you, right? So in your case, you just talked about your own memory experience and you listened to Takaya's story, right?
Yeah.
So what did you specifically think about his experience?
Oh.
Do you have any idea?
So 自分がその Takaya のそのあの話を聞いて思ったのは、待ってみますよ、思ったのは、その自分にもその東北に親戚がいるっていうのはその知ってたけれども、そこまでなんだ心配する余裕は自分にはなかったなっていうのを今この話を聞いて思いました。
Well, I think it is really unfortunate, but I couldn't really afford to think about othersother than my family members, because I was in a really difficult condition, even in my family. So I didn't really have extra mind to think about the other family members living in Tohoku. So what about you? Do you have any idea or your opinion about his own experience?
まあやっぱりそのシュウメイさんがさっき言っていたように、まあ僕と同じようにその電気とか何も使えないってことはやっぱりすごい、まあ不自由なことだし、もう何もかもできなくなってしまうっていうふうなことはやっぱあるんですね。そこですごい なんて言ったらいいんだろうな。それが逆に怖さを倍増させていくというか、痛苦な経験はすごい僕も感じたので、ちょっと怖かったなと思います。
Yes, so, actually we both talked about the, outage of electricity and water and, infrastructure, and it is really important for us to, you know, live our daily lives. And without water, we're gonna definitely die, right? And without food, we're gonna die as well. And without electricity, we can't charge the battery on our phone. And everything is cut off. And even in a current society, the smartphones and electricity and water and food are everything's equal to our lives. So losing electricity means almost equal to losing our life. So when I heard about his story, I was really surprised and I was really shocked. And I even felt some fear about the things happening, or things that might happen in the future. Yes. So, actually, those two guests and those two teachers are not exactly living and were not living in Tohoku when the earthquake happens. I mean, in 2011. You were in Kanagawa, right?
Right.
In your house. So you're not in Tohoku area. So you didn't really experience the tsunami or earthquake as well as the Doris living in Tohoku at that time, right? Okay. So you didn't exactly see tsunami.
Yeah, we just saw the tsunami from TV.
Yeah, from TV. You too?
Yeah.
So, but still in metropolitan area, like, I mean, Tokyo, Kanagawa, Yokohama city, big city, other than those areas directly hit by the earthquakes, trains are stopped, and we had some people like who couldn't go home because of the train, you know, operation has just stopped, and transportation was hit by the, you know, earthquakes, and we had a lot of people called kitakunami. Yeah, so we are now like the age. At the age of the 19 or 20 this year, then we definitely have some opportunity or chances, the fatal, to face such situation that we cannot go home. For example, on the way home from the university or workplace. So if you are the kitakunami at that time, how do you react to the situation? I guess it's a really hard question, but your answer is going to definitely help the viewers. So I want you to share your opinions about it.
大学から帰宅できない場合か。
場合どうしたらいいか。
They are actually really worried about the answers. Yeah, it's really hard, I know. Yeah, but still.
一番簡単なのってはあれだよね。その現状維持っていうかそのとどまること大学にが一番簡単なのかな。
Yeah, so easiest way is just stay in a university campus and spend time with friends and, you know, professors and teachers or any other adults. Yeah. But, you know, the problem was a lack of food and drink. Of course, we have some storage and, you know, we have some stock of the food and drink in order to, you know, survive even in such a situation. But still, if a lot of people evacuate and stay in university campus, probably they face a thirst and lack of food and drink. Yeah. So, still, we can't decide the which idea is the best. Right?
Yeah.
So what about you?
多分その、まあ、なんだろう。大学に留まるか、その家に留まるかっていう風な時に、まあ今自分がどこにいるかっていう風なものを僕は考えた方が良いと思ってて、もし仮に大学の そばであれば大学に帰るっていう風なものが最も正しい、ベストな判断だと僕は思っているし、もし家のそばにいれば、そのまま家に帰ってしまっても、僕は問題ないんじゃないかなと思ってます。
Yes, so what exactly matters when the earthquake happens is like the place、we're in, we're at, in the, under the current circumstance. So now, like, for example, if we are in university or any places near the university, we should go back to the university and stay there. But if they are apart from the university, we should go back home orWe should find any other places to evacuate. Yeah. So, he said, everything matters is like the places you're at. Yes. So, by doing so, you can choose the way, you know, way of evacuating in which place you evacuate to. Yeah. So it's really hard. But do you have any questions to each other?
なんかある?
Now, I want you to come up with a lot of, you know, interesting topics and interesting questions that catch their heart. Yeah. So, I want you to think of it.
コメント OK.
Or a question.
Question?
To him.
あ、俺、なかったら普通にコメントでもいいし。
Yes, yes. Comment or question.
じゃあコメント。多分そういうふうなその災害とかっていつ起こるか全くわからないんですね、もう誰も。
Yes, so no one can expect the, when the earthquakes or natural disaster happens, because it's really natural.
だから普段から訓練とかをしっかりと僕は行うべきだと思っていて、そういう訓練とかを怠ってはいけないと思ってます。
Yes, so the, actually, under the policy,of Japanese education, still a lot of people, all the children and the students need to, you know, undergo some training of evacuation at school. Or even in a company, like probably all the employees should explain, experience the, evacuation training in the office. So it is really important to be really serious, always stay serious about the training.And even in the, during the training, although it's just a training, you should consider the training as a reality, real thing, real earthquake or natural disaster, so that you're going to be definitely helped or you can survive. And because you have a lot of knowledge and, you know, experience through training. So, training is not to be degraded.So you always have to consider the training as the most important thing in your life. Yes.
あともう一つあって。
One thing.
決してこういうふうな災害のことを忘れちゃいけないと。
Yes. So the second important point is not to forget the natural disaster happened in the past.
すごく大変で、もう辛かったこともたくさんあるかもしれないけども、こういうふうなことがもしかしたらもうちょっとしてから起こるかもしれないので、そういうふうなことはどんどん後の世代に昔こういうことがあったんだってことをしっかりと伝えていくのが我々の使命でもあると思ってます。
So, some people experiencing the natural disasters including the 3.11 earthquake might have some mental disease or a really unfortunate and fatalthing experienced during that time, but still, it is our motto, like, it's the role that we need to play in order to save the future lives and future children. So from me, if you're parents and if you have your own children, I want you to save them andI want you to teach and I want you to educate them about the natural disasters.
じゃあ俺からもそのさっきその高井が言ったことのその補足というかなんだけども、その情報の共有っていうのはやっぱすごい大事で、もしそういう災害にあった時とかに最低限そのどこに集まるべきかとかそういうのを知っておくだけでも家族にその会える可能性が高まるから、それは重要。 だし、そのさっき言ってたけども、そのこの災害の記憶っていうのを今後も未来へこう伝えるっていうのは、その当たり前だけどすごい大事な重要なことだと思います。
Yes, so、for me、as all the teachers at school tells you to decide and、set the place to evacuate and talk about them, talk about those kind of issues and things with your family member or、those who live with you、so that、you can、evacuate properly and in a safer way. So、first of all, I want you to discuss the things about the natural disasters, for example, where to evacuate and、which to bring to the evacuation places. For example, if you have、some bag, an emergency bag,、which contains a Band-Aid and some, for example, water and what else? Emergency food.
Food, yes.
Yeah, I want you to bring them together. So、anyways,he says the most important thing is to discuss the things. If the earthquake happens, what would you do? Yeah? So that might be the most important point. Yes. Then also,、I want you to keep、telling the story.Or real thing happening to、us to those who is going to be、you know, play a big role in our society in the future. You know, in our future society, for example, the current children and a small baby and tiny and cute adorable babies,、they're going to definitely play a big part in our society. So I want them to、know.About、the history of Japan. So, education is also important. Yeah. Okay, so at the end of the video, do you have any comments?
Tomorrow.
I mean, for tomorrow. Yeah.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
Ah, そうですね。その3.11っていう節目の10年目っていう節目の時にちゃんと映像とかで改めて振り返っていうのは、さっきから何回も言ってるけど、とても重要なことだと思います。
Yes, so、as I already told you at the beginning of the video、today it's 10th of March and of course tomorrow it's going to be 11th of March and it's going to be the 10th anniversary of theearthquake, and、it is significant for you to review the, all the things happening 10 years ago through the TV programs or any documentary videos on YouTube or story heard from other people, and it is really important not to forget.
はい。まあ、明日で、その震災から10年が経ちますけども、今、こうやってコロナとかのニュースですごい世界では、ニュースが溢れ返っているけれども、震災のことも同じように、絶対に忘れちゃいけないことなので、皆さん忘れないでください。
Yes, so, under the current circumstance, there are a lot of news spreading out about the COVID-19. And of course, a lot of people are suffering with the virus and, still,That is really near, it's really abnormal, and everyone do not really know about the virus, and it's really scary. But、even if the corona is going to spread out widely all over the world, and、we have to carefully think about the virus, the most important thing is not to forget the things happening in the past. Yeah, of course, corona is important, but...again, important point is not to forget the things happening in the history. So, the 3.11 is the one of the important history. And Yeah, so it's really crucial thing to review and not to forget the history. Yeah. So some people degrade the history and they sometimes say, oh, history is not important. It's just silly. We don't have to learn history, but history made what we are today. History made what we are today. So without history, we are not here. Thanks to the history, the Japanese people are recreated, rebuilt, and this country is rebuilt. So please keep in mind that history is important. So do not forget the things about 3.11 earthquake happening in northern part of Japan. Okay, so let's pray. Okay, so thank you everyone for watching our long videos today, but I hope it's gonna help you to at least remember the Japanese history, and you could learn something, a little, even tiny thing from our video. So if you're interested in our channel more and more, I want you to subscribe and leave a like in our description page. And we also have some detailed information in our website. So again, if you're interested in, I want you to check it out. And we have some Zoom consultations. So if you're interested in, I want you to visit them as well. Okay, thank you everyone. And please pray for the those who suffered the mental disease or, you know, the physical diseases, and those who are dead because of the earthquake. Okay, so thank you everyone for watching our videos. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.